Hey, welcome back to the channel. My name is Daniel, and today I want to talk to you about a new tool that's going to be available to creators, and it's from TubeBuddy. Now, full disclosure, I do work for TubeBuddy. That's where the cool t-shirt came from, and the coffee mug. Now, most of you are familiar with the Tag Explorer tool, but the new keyword tool is going to be focused on helping you find titles and keywords that can drive more traffic to your content. I've had about a day to play with this tool, and I want to walk you through some of the functionality of the new keyword tool. The first thing you'll notice when you open up the TubeBuddy Keyword Explorer is that it looks a little different than the Tag Explorer. The very first prompt is to type in a keyword search term that you'd like to explore. As you type, you'll see that the Keyword Explorer will automatically populate the dropdown with keyword search terms and phrases it knows are relevant to your search. Right off the bat, this is ridiculously helpful when you only sort of know the topic you might want to explore, but don't have the exact search terms locked down in your brain yet. For my tech channel friends, let's say that you want to make a video about the iPhone XS Max, one of the hot new Apple iPhones that seems everyone is making videos about. And the first thing we'll see is what TubeBuddy calls our unweighted overall score. We get a 7 out of 100. Yikes, a 7. This is a horrible target for us, and TubeBuddy goes ahead and breaks the keyword score down in the analysis section below to tell us exactly why this is a bad target. The search volume is high. That means a lot of people search for this term, which is great, but the competition is very high. Everybody is making videos about this one, and if you make one too, you'll be at the back of the line behind every other video that is already performing for this search term. But here's a new bar that you may not be used to seeing, the optimization strength bar. By clicking on the question mark next to it, TubeBuddy tells us that this represents how well optimized the top ranking videos are for the search phrase. If they're not well optimized, then it provides you an opportunity to break in and rank for the keyword by properly optimizing your video. And by clicking on the results tab, we can actually see the competition is very well optimized in their titles and descriptions for that particular keyword search term. TubeBuddy highlights those optimization factors in yellow to show you what strong optimization looks like. Take note of this when you go to create your titles and descriptions. Now keep in mind, this tool might evolve and change over time, so it might look a little different as it develops and some of the functions are refined. So now we know making a video with iPhone XS Max as the title would make it extremely hard to get our video discovered by anyone in the target audience we're trying to put it in front of. But here's where things get awesome. If we look over to the right, TubeBuddy provides us with a related box that contains related video searches, related web-based searches, and related video topics to help us find better keyword search terms about the iPhone XS Max that we can potentially craft our titles and video around. The great thing about this tool is some of it is actually free to use, and other portions are going to be available to paid license holders. So free users will be able to see the top 3 results in each section. This gives us a whole host of potential targets that we can make our next video about. Notice that all of the search terms and related topics have a box next to them that you can click so that you can copy them to your clipboard or tag list and save them for later. You can even create new tag list group titles to organize and pull them up quickly later on. So knowing this search term is out of our reach, let's try using the video topics tab and scroll down a bit. Let's try, how does dual SIM work on iPhone XS Max? If we click on that, TubeBuddy automatically loads that keyword search phrase into the Keyword Explorer and boom! Now we have a good score and the score analysis underneath. We know this term has an overall lower search volume, but it has very low competition. And of the videos that rank for this search term, they are very poorly optimized for this keyword search phrase. If you're a smaller tech channel trying to figure out how you can make a video about the new iPhone XS Max that could actually rank in search and suggested, this could be your way to put your foot in the door by making a video about how the dual SIM feature works on the iPhone XS Max and using this as your title. You can now figure out what your video should be about before you even start to film. TubeBuddy. One quick note, if you look at the bottom of the Keyword Explorer, you'll see that it saves your recent keyword searches, as well as the score for each right next to it, so that you can easily compare different keyword search terms and decide what you might want to make your next video about. You can also click on them to quickly recall the data for each term that you've researched. Now, this information just completely changed your opportunity to make a video that could actually rank on YouTube. But wait, it gets even better. If you have a Pro TubeBuddy license or above, you'll have the option to click on the weighted overall score. TubeBuddy now takes into consideration how your channel has performed on average, and it calculates and compares what your channel's odds are of being able to rank for this search term based on your channel's performance. You'll see the overall score adjusts with this new information, and a new bit of information shows up at the bottom of the score analysis. I love this feature. TubeBuddy shows us the average amount of views that the top ranking videos have, the average amount of views that your videos tend to get across your channel, and right in the middle, you'll see the target views. If you hover over that, you'll see this represents the lowest view count video, or more specifically, how many views the smallest performing video had, but was still able to rank for this search term. Listen very closely to me here. This is your target. Let me explain. If you can make a video for this keyword search term title and beat this score with strong content that can drive more than this amount of views, you could potentially rank for this keyword search term. When people search for this term, your video could show up near the top of search results and get suggested next to other similar content. Imagine that, your video at the top of YouTube search results. And if you can make many solid content-based videos that all start to rank for their optimized keyword titles, then your channel can really start to grow. Now, we can learn a lot more about the search target by clicking the trending tab, which gives us a deep dive into the rising related or trending searches or queries, as well as the top related searches in the past 12 months. The historical tab gives us a graph of how often this has been searched in the past, which is great for determining if your target is a trending or evergreen topic. And the maps tab will give us global information as to how important this search term is to the region you might be targeting. I'm going to be digging deeper into the other tabs of this amazing tool, but for today, I wanted to get you going right away with the new TubeBuddy Keyword Explorer tool for your very next upload. So there you have it, the new keyword tool from TubeBuddy. This is going to change the way you think about creating content. If you have any questions about the new tool, drop them in the comments section below and we'll continue this conversation. And don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe if you've learned anything here today. TubeBuddy.
Peace.